right, so last time we did some research about a famous artist. Now we're going to be getting into creating your own original idea for your painting, okay? How to make an interesting painting. There is no magical formula to make an interesting painting. However, there is a formula for making a boring painting. Paintings that are about nothing are kind of boring. I mean, if I looked at that painting, I guess it's a flower, maybe you like flowers, but it doesn't really say anything. We're going to attempt to make paintings that have some sort of meaning behind them. You need to be able to explain what the meaning behind your painting is. Why did you paint it, okay? So we are going to pull from three different places to pull out our ideas. The first one is art history. We've already started working on that. We've done some research on some famous artists that you like. The two other places we're going to look are your own personal experiences. And then there's also the world around us. So that means like things that are affecting the world on a global or national scale. I'll show you some examples. Personal experiences. A lot of artists are famous for working particularly about things that happened to them. There's Van Gogh there. You can see he's got the, if you know this story, he cut off a piece of his own ear. Oh my goodness. But it did make for a great painting. Now, I'm not asking you to cut off a piece of your own ear. But if there is something interesting in your life that you would like to document, that is, a painting is a good way to do it. There's The Scream by Edvard Munch, and this was actually from a personal experience that he had when he was walking through a fjord, and he had sort of a crazy intense panic attack, and he documented that in this painting. If you have strongly held religious convictions, that is a great thing to put into a painting. There is a massive history of religious painting. So if that's something you care about, that is a great thing that you could do to put into a painting. They don't all have to be crazy wild experiences. This is by an artist named David Hockney, and he was, when he moved to California, he just loved the way the swimming pools looked and the reflections in the water and the blue sky and the palm trees, and he worked that into his paintings. This one is by Toulouse-Lautrec. He was an artist in Paris. He loved painting the nightlife there, the Moulin Rouge and the people partying late into the evening, and he would make paintings of that. So it was his life. So using your own personal experiences is a great place to start. Take a look through photographs that you have, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, whatever you got. Grab your phone, take a see what you got on there. Look for something that is from your personal experience that made a great image that you would like to recapture in a painting. It's a great place to start. Other artists are famous for making commentary about the world around us. Banksy's probably the most famous guy working right now that we don't even know what he looks like, but he does graffiti art, usually has a political message, usually for working class people or oppression. But there's lots of artists that worked about things that political beliefs. This is by Shepard Fairey. He did the Hope poster. That was he was not commissioned to do that. He did that out of his own inspiration, and it became an inspiration for others. So if you have strong, powerful beliefs, putting them into a painting is a great thing to do. So we did look at some famous artists that you guys looked at. How do you translate that into your own work? Well, usually it's like you're not going to be copying their paintings, but what you're going to be doing is you can use their painting style. So how they're using brush technique or color palette. So saving an image from an artist that you worked on and having it there for comparison is very helpful. You know, you can hold the palette right up next to the screen and see how your colors are comparing. And it's the subtle things. If you look at this, you don't really notice it at first, but like even this one, you can see this is not just pure white. There's lots of grays in there, almost like, some browns. The shadow is not just, they didn't just do a shadow with black. These are blues and there's greens and purples and stuff going on in there. Using the artist that you looked at and really seeing how they use their colors. A lot of folks like this guy, Wayne, and he has some pretty specific style way of painting, you know, using these big flat cool colors in the background, but then like these pops of like bright saturated bits of color, like you can see this yellow bits and reds, these bright blue shadows with purples. Okay, so if you're gonna follow, if this was your artist and you wanted to copy his style, you know, you really want to have some of these photographs open on your computer while you're painting so you can go back and use them as reference. There's an example of someone who liked Wayne's style and so used his style, but they painted Chinese food. Yummy. Impressionist style is pretty popular if you like this. They're most famous for these little brush strokes, these little quick brush strokes. A lot of different impressionist artists used them. There's one, they did a koi pond, but they did it in kind of impressionist style. This one is about the world around us as well. So this is about deforestation, but it's done in an impressionist style. You got some impressionist clouds up there too. So Surratt style is even more extreme than regular impressionist. It's done with lots of little tiny dots. And you can achieve this by, instead of using a paintbrush, I do have some Q-tips, and you guys can use Q-tips to make the dots. A lot of folks like Magritte. He's pretty famous for these blue skies with clouds. Now, if you get to the point that you're like, oh, I want to try and put some Magritte-style clouds into mine, that's great, but you may go, I don't know how to do that. Well, that's what the internet's for. Do some research. You just go onto the YouTubes, and there's tons of stuff about how to paint clouds. So you do want to do some research on whatever style that you are doing. There's one that was a photograph from a student that was on vacation on this beach, and they really wanted to try and capture the sand and the surf and the sky. They spent a lot of time on those clouds, making them fluffy, making them look nice. Chuck Close did a lot of work with photorealism, so he makes these super large, ultra-realistic paintings, and he used a technique called a grid technique, where you go square by square, you map it out. If you want to try a grid technique, we can do that, but there is kind of another shortcut you can use, which is using the projector. If you are working from a photograph, I will allow you guys to use a projector. So you can take a photograph of yourself, or if you have a photograph you'd like to use, you can get clearance from me. I'm not going to give it to everybody. It depends on your project, but a lot of you guys, I will let you use the projector, and there's a Chuck Close style portrait right there. A lot of artists are famous for working from black and white photos. That is another thing you can do, taking your photos, going into Photoshop or whatever program, and changing the color around or making them black and white. Banksy's pretty famous, Andy Warhol, working with photographs as well. You know, there's the one that's inspired by Banksy there. There's another one. There's Grandma Moses. Very nice. These big pastoral scenes of little tiny people in a landscape. It's a fun one to do. This one's got little tiny people in a landscape. It has a giant crab. I don't remember why. This was a few years ago. But it's a great giant crab. So we're going to make an idea sketch in your book. So grab from those places. Art, history, personal experiences, or the world around us, okay? It's best to combine from multiple sources. You definitely want to take something from those artists you looked at, then either your personal or the world around us, and make a big mixture of it together, and try and make a painting that you would want to look at that you're proud of. All right.